this, 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 and up to this much, this much. So what is delivered, completed, and settled, that will be the utmost priority, because people would want to know results. Because when it comes to Prime Minister Modi, people are interested in what, how you deliver. So I think this cabinet is very apt to deliver this. Coming to your question in pertinent, you see, Vineet, I've been always maintaining on your channel, Twitter is playing games with India. And these OTT platforms, you know, they think they can have a free run in India. You know, like Twitter was trying to provoke a lot of provocations, was trying to block the account of Ravi Shankar Prasad, he was trying to block the account of our deputy president, vice president of India, and hoping that we will do a knee-jerk reaction and that will give the fodder in the courts which they can use against us. And, you know, then there will be a gag ready, Vineet. You'll see freedom of expression, Patan, Black Day, Constitution violated, the, you know, Washington Post, New York Times, all the articles would have been ready. Now the point is that we have to get into a proactive state. Let's forget being a reactive. We need 1.3 billion people, the largest democracy of the world. Jack Dorsey cannot teach us how to have freedom of expression. He's nobody to lecture us on a democracy. He's nobody to talk about freedom of expression in India when he runs a for-profit corporate entity. So these are the things which we were handling on a reactive mode. What are we doing to handle them on a proactive mode? We have seen this standoff fiasco. You know, how has the law delivery system changed in India last 7 years? Have we accelerated the delivery of law? How many cases are still pending in the courts? How many judges need to be recruited? No, what is the, you know, tenure of an average case? Has it come down? So there are, these are practical, hard-hitting realities on the ground which need to be accelerated. And I agree with Joyataji when she says it's not necessary a health minister has to be a doctor. Then why BK Singh was not given the defense ministry? Why Rajnath Singh? Because at times, if you believe, if you can give me a minute, last time around, you have seen a couple of this. I answered to what Dr. Shastri said last time. You see, what happened last time? Delhi said, I need four times the oxygen. When the Supreme Court panel intervenes and finds the oxygen requirement was 1/4. Delhi was having needing four times oxygen than Maharashtra and Karnataka. Maybe people in Delhi have bigger lungs, four times the size of the nation. I mean, this was happening. There was politicization of the pandemic happening. There were people coming on TV saying, "Ek ghante ka oxygen hai, I don't have vaccines. I have to close these many vaccination centers." Today, vaccines are available and ample. Why we are not hitting 1 million target, 10 million target, that should be asked. Why Delhi is not number one, that should be asked. Why Delhi doesn't want to come and say, I'm number one in whole of India. You know, when you were coming and telling, after every 2 hours, I'm closing this center, I'm closing that center, mere paas vaccination nahi hai, oxygen nahi hai. Then you simply said, oh, I did a multiplication and an oxygen management. You know, there are things, unfortunately, there are some people who have politicized the pandemic or politicized the disaster. So this time around, management of pandemic without the resources and logistics becomes more important. Politically, handling of pandemic becomes more important than the medical things. Because medically today, we know more about what to happen. We increase our infrastructure. We produce more oxygen. We increase the 30% production of oxygen. But the problem was in the distribution. The problem was in when people were demanding, you know, the cases were going down, but my oxygen demand was doubling. So these kind of things have to be controlled. And this perception was going out in the international media. India is starving out of oxygen. There's no oxygen in India. But see the amount of work the government has done in this point of time. And let me answer Mr. Shastri. Sir, Jai Shankar Ji, Nirmala Sitharaman Ji, Ravan Ji is from Tamil Nadu. Mr. Murugan yesterday into cabinet from Tamil Nadu. Four new ministers from Kerala, Mr. Reddy from Andhra. So let's not get this north-south divide. I agree with Jayataji when she says that's personal delivery. Then when I look at J&K as a full state, there is only one minister, Jitendra Ji. Minus that, there is nobody else. So if we start picking up these mix and my why four from Gujarat, why one from J&K, this is not going to take us anywhere. And we need last point I want to make. If you look at UP, 80 seats are around 15% of the total seats in India. Now, if you look at the ministers, 7 out of 43 is again 15%. Now, these aspersions that you're cast, Yogi is not doing well, UP is going to be a debacle, BJP is slipping ground, UP is missing. That is why this reshuffle is done. If it was a UP-centric reshuffle, then you would have 20 cases from UP, not 7 out of 43. UP got what it deserves vis-a-vis parliamentary seats and vis-a-vis in proportion. 15%, 15%. So where are these things? Where are these aspersions being passed? It is the time, Vineet. We as a country have been hit by this goddamn Chinese virus. And if you talk of the fatality in India, look at the fatality in US, look at the infections in India, compare them in US. US has the best infrastructure, most advanced country, most developed country. Do the numbers. Numbers have the answer. Now Mr. Shastri can come and say we are hiding.
Okay, let him respond.
This is casting aspersions. This is not fair, Vineet. This is not fair. We can't count.
Okay,
that.
Let him respond. Let him respond. Sumit, let him respond.
My perceptions cannot supersede data.
Right, let him respond. Mr. Shastri, we also spoke about the focus on South. There's obviously